Hello and welcome back, everyone. So Kennedy's classification, which was of course proposed by Dr. Edward Kennedy himself, classifies the partially edentulous state into four different classes based on the position of the absent teeth, which could then be treated with a removable partial denture. This classification basically allows us to formulate a treatment plan, making it easier to communicate between professionals and also easier for visualization of an edentulous arc. So let's look into the Kennedy's four classes. So first, the class one, which states that bilaterally edentulous area located posterior to the remaining natural teeth. So this over here is a representation of a dentition of a single jaw, and I will be using this image as a reference in my further discussions. So the teeth were absent on both sides, that is the right and the left side, like over here. The first, second and third molars of both sides are absent, and also this edentulous area is behind the remaining natural teeth. Therefore, this edentulous state will be classified as class 1. So the next class, the class 2, states that unilateral edentulous area located posterior to the remaining natural teeth. So now the teeth are absent only on the one side, either on the left or on the right, and are still behind the remaining natural teeth. So this state will be classified as class 2. So the next, class 3, states that a unilateral edentulous area with natural teeth both anterior and posterior to it. So for an edentulous area to be classified into class 3, it needs to have a unilateral edentulous area between the natural teeth. Like in this case, the second premolar and the first molar is missing, and this edentulous area is located between the remaining natural teeth. Therefore, it is classified as class 3. And finally, the class 4 states that a single but bilateral edentulous area located anterior to the remaining natural teeth. So like over here is a bilateral edentulous area because it is crossing the midline, but it is still a single area because there are no teeth present in between. So it is still a single but bilateral edentulous area crossing the midline. So therefore it is classified into class 4. So these were the four classes of Kennedy's classification of edentulous states. So next we have the Applegate's rule, which are in total 8 rules proposed by Applegate for helping us to classify multiple edentulous areas and also for the better understanding and better application of Kennedy's classification in our everyday life. So let's go through these 8 rules. So the rule number 1 states that classification should follow rather than precede any extraction of the teeth that might alter the original classification. So this rule basically means that the classification of the edentulous state should be done after any extraction has been performed, not before the extraction, since the extraction of the teeth may alter the classification. Like this arc is right now a class 3, but if I were to extract the second and the third molars, now this arc is no longer class 3, rather it has now become class 2. So this rule basically means that classification should always be done after the performing the extractions. So the next rule states, if the third molar is missing and is not to be replaced, it will not be considered in the classification. So like in this example, both the third molars are missing as well as the first molar on one side is missing. So we will not classify it as class 1, we will classify it as class 3 according to the missing first molar. The same goes if the third molar is only missing on one side. If we have no intentions of replacing this third molar on the other side, we will simply not consider it while classifying the edentulous state. So this will still be class 3 state. So the next rule states that if the third molar is present and it is to be used as an abutment, it is considered in the classification. So an abutment is basically the tooth from which the denture takes its support from. So we'll take the same example as the previous case. So if in this case we are going to use the present third molar as an abutment for our denture, then we will include it in the classification. So now since we are going to use this third molar as a support for our denture, therefore this will now be classified as class 2 modification 1. So I will explain about the modifications in the rule number 6, so don't worry about that. So the next rule, rule number 4, states that if the second molar is missing and not to be replaced, it is not considered in the classification. So like in this case, we are missing the second molar and the third molars on the both sides. Along with that, we are also missing two premolars, but only on the one side. So if we have no intentions of replacing these absent second molars, we will not include them in the classification and we will simply classify it as class 3. And the same goes if the second molar is absent only on the one side as it was with the third molar. Moving on, rule number 5 states that the most posterior edentulous area always determines the classification. So like in this example, there are two different edentulous areas. So according to the rule, we will classify according to the most posterior edentulous area. So in this example, we will classify it as class 3 modification 1. So the next rule basically explains the modification system. It states that the edentulous area other than those that determine the classification are referred to as modifications and are designated by their numbers. So this example over here will be classified as class 3 modification 2 because there are two additional edentulous area other than this one that is determining the classification. So the one that is determining the classification will not be included in the modification, while the rest of the edentulous area will be known as modifications. So the second last rule, rule 7, states that extent of modification is not considered, only the number of additional areas is considered. Like in this example over here, there are many edentulous areas. So according to Kennedy's classification, it will be classified as class 3. Now since both sides have the same number of missing teeth, so you can take any one side for the classification. So for me, I'm going to take this side. So this is now class 3, modification 1, 2 and 3. So this example over here is class 3, modification 3. So as you can see, there are multiple missing teeth in each of the areas, but still they are considered as a single modification. So basically the number of teeth absent are irrelevant, only the number of edentulous areas is what matters. And in this case, there are three additional edentulous areas, therefore it is known as class 3 modification 3. So now the final rule states that no modification area can be included in class 4. So over here, according to Kennedy's classification, is a class 4 because the edentulous area is crossing the midline and is located anterior to the remaining natural teeth. But if in this example, if I remove a second molar, so now it will not be class 4 modification 1. Because rule number 5 states that the most posterior edentulous area always determines the classification. So this has now become class 3 modification 1. Similarly, if I remove these two remaining first and second molars, so this has now become class 2 modification 1. And finally, if I remove the molars on the opposite side as well, so it will then become class 1 modification 1. So basically what I mean to say is that all the classes can have modifications except for class 4, which can never have a modification. So that's all for Kennedy's classification. If you still have any confusions, please do comment down below and I will try my best to answer them. So please take care of yourselves and I will see you people next time. Goodbye.